Okay, I was figuring I'd mess around with this 7/8 Lee slug again. Make up some different loadings, and then when the range opens, we can give them a try. I've been messing with the 20 gauge one. And I did some stuff with the 7/8 slug years ago. I had a loading video, which is actually fairly popular, surprisingly. But I only had these wads here. These are the Winchester AA. And I got these two other ones here recently. This is a Claybuster. This is Lightning or something is the name of it. It's like a 1 ounce or something, I guess, or 7/8, somewhere around there. And this is a Federal, I think it's like S0 or SO. I think it's O as in zero, I believe, but anyway. I think this is like their 7/8 around, or 7/8 or... A lot of places say it's 7/8 or 1 ounce, so... It's got this weird kind of twirly looking base on it. But I figured it would... They seem like they work pretty good with the slugs, and you just put like a card underneath of it. I got like 20 gauge nitro cards that go underneath. Give you the right height and everything. So these ones here, I loaded some of these the other day in these hulls. These are Federal gold metal, but they got a flat, like the base wad is basically flat right across, so they got quite a bit of capacity, so I figured they'd be good for maybe black powder or something, but I loaded a few that are sort of, I don't know, just plinking loads or something. I put 60 grains of 1F GOX, which is like the biggest scoop in the Lee set. It's like 59.8 or whatever it says on the chart. But put that in, and then one of these wads on it. And then a couple cards, and then the slug, and it actually crimps like perfect. So, here. See, they crimp all nice and everything. But if you cut the base wad off, you probably could, put a heavier charge of black in it. Might try that as well. I don't know how fast that'd be going. They're probably not going too quick. But these ones, it's kind of this weird cushion part on it. It's probably easy to cut that off. But then, like, this is a bit more complex, I guess. But actually, the Winchester ones are probably pretty easy. Get those weird little legs. So you cut that off and probably use it in these brass holes or something. Put the powder and then a couple, probably need a cushion wad or something or a nitro card, and then just sit this on top of it. I don't know how you'd, I guess you could put a card over it and glue it in. I'm not sure how you'd seal that, but we'll figure that out when we get there, I guess. But I suppose you could do the same with this in here. Figure out with the wad column, but when you put like a, I don't know, like 90 or 100 grains of black powder in a 12 gauge, usually they come up quite a bit, but this hull it might be less, but I got lots of like 12 gauge cushion wads and stuff. That'd be kind of neat, I guess. Because you use the black powder, it's like a bigger boom and everything, but it doesn't usually kick as hard as like smokeless does. But especially those 60 grain ones, they'd be pretty weak, I would imagine. But anyway, at least I got something to mess with here anyway. I might try some, load some more with Unique or something, because the old loads I think was Unique powder, the Winchester wad, and 7/8 slugs and stuff. But they seem to work okay, but I try them like in one or two different guns, and you do a little bit more testing with them, I think. But, because I know like those 20 gauge slugs actually seem to like, they seem like they got potential. It's kind of cool to get the 12 gauge big air rifle pellet looking one, but But they seem to work pretty good. Kind of nice to make work up a load that would work for deer hunting and stuff. So, anyway, thanks for watching, guys. So, talk to you later.